after the video about the 360 degrees photo shoot, I got many questions from people asking how I edit the 360 degrees photos. So I thought I make a short video about how I edit those photos. Maybe there are other ways to do it, but this is my workflow and goes rather quickly. I already opened two photos in Photoshop. I work with Photoshop and Lightroom. First, I do everything in Photoshop. Then I export the photo and import the photo in Lightroom again. And from there, I continue. So, let me show you. Here's the photo in Photoshop. And you see it's a 360 degrees photo. And the first thing I do is I click on 3D. Spherical panorama, new panorama, layer from selected layer. Click on that. And then there is your 360 degrees photo. You can just move it around however you want. Sometimes you see in a 360 degree photo a small dot here, a red dot, and taking that out. So, taking the spot healing and it's gone. Now we go to the tripod, and you see the tripod has a shadow as well. So we have to take out both. Healing, and it's gone. Here as well, the tripod. A little bit more, and that's it. In grass it's pretty easy. And then you go to 3D again, spherical panorama, export panorama, and you choose a name and export it. That's easy. Another example. A bathroom. It's a bit trickier. You see it's a bit yellow, but I won't change the colors here in Photoshop. I do it in Lightroom. So again, 3D, spherical panorama, new panorama. And then here's a mirror. So the camera is in the mirror, but I will take it out. There's a tripod, and we have to deal with the shadow here as well. So first I will take out the tripod on the floor. It's a marble floor, so it already has some stains. Okay, let me go back to the move tool. And there is the tripod. So now I do a little zoom. That, and then like this, make sure it's far enough, and it's gone. That's easy. Then we go to the move tool again, going down on the other side, because now we're gonna take out this shadow here like this. Make it a little bit wider, so we make sure that everything is gone, and it's gone. Now again, export panorama, and you can save it. So that's easy. Then we are going to open it in Lightroom, and the same photo is open already. So I go to the basic slider. You see here that it's a little bit highlighted, so I do a little bit the highlight. I lower the highlight here as well, boost the shadows a little bit, colors, make them the sky a little darker, and the grass a little darker. That's actually it. It's very easy. Then we export it. I'll show you. Rename, that's all fine. Of course, the 100% quality. Don't resize it. And we sharpen it for the screen high. Because, of course, you always watch the 360 degrees virtual tours on a screen. So then you have to sharpen for a screen. Export, then it says give unique names. Okay, unique name. Then the one of the bathroom. Of course, I have to deal with the white balance because it's not good. So I picked a dropper. And then it's better, but not as good as I want. So I do a little bit manually. Highlights, back, shadows a little bit better. Here as well, the highlights. So now you can see there's no highlights, there's no darks. And then with this, with the color, I make it a little bit darker. So the bathroom is this color, it's a bit orangey. And that's it. Then again, export. And it's done. So let me show you the end result. First, from the back of the property, you can have a look around here. And you see you can't see anything about from the tripod anymore. And here is the bathroom without the camera and the mirror, of course. And here also you can walk around. And the tripod is gone as well. So you see, it's pretty easy to do. Just use Photoshop and Lightroom, save it, and you can make your 360 degrees tour. If you would like to see the end result of this property, I will put a link in the description below. I hope this information was helpful. If you can use it in your workflow, give it a thumbs up. And then I thank you for watching and I see you in the next video. Bye.